varying amounts of experience who come from different backgrounds and often view the world differently.
We're definitely not perfect, but we are all brethren and we're all committed to this piece of rock called Jamaica.
Too often, there are no safe spaces for men to explore the issues which are important to us.
Plus, most of the content out there about parenthood is produced by women, for women. So we think it is important that we be the change we want to see.
Follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Jamaican Dads with a Z.
And definitely join us here on Nationwide 90 FM every Thursday at 8 p.m. with a repeat on Sundays at 6 p.m. for the Jamaican Dads podcast. It's a revolution in media.
Get ready for a show like no other. That's right. Every Sunday from 8:15 p.m. to 9:15 p.m., we're bringing you The Harvest Hour, only on Nationwide 90 FM. Join us as we dive into a soothing religious program created for your mind, body, and soul. The World Harvest Mission Church, creators of The Harvest Hour, is dedicated to making your Sundays God-fearing and saintly. Get a front row seat to moving sermons and affectionate worshiping. That's The Harvest Hour, every Sunday from 8:15 p.m. to 9:15 p.m. Only on Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media.
Listen to Nationwide 90 FM on
90.1, 90.3,
90.7,
90.9.
Or visit our flow channel on a 916. To our valued listeners for questions, comments, or concerns about our programs, email us at programs@nationwidenewsnetwork.com.
We interrupt this program for an important announcement.
Vulture! I'm in a big mood.
You're now inside NNN's entertainment block.
Bless me, baptize.
Radio's premier afternoon experience. Your one-stop shop for all things music, culture, creativity, and entertainment.
You make me wanna run, run, run.
You deserve that break, so come take it with us inside the entertainment block. Let's stay trending as we rethink afternoon radio.
Baby, when the bright lights start to fade.
So catch the vibe and ride the wave every day, 1 to 5 p.m. right here on Nationwide 90 FM, your new revolution in media.
Three, two, one.
Welcome to Nationwide's Entertainment Block, your number one choice in afternoon radio.
You ready?
Yeah. You know, I fully body bad God attack, you know. You represent for the sound of. I mean, I say, yo, Karen, yo, Triple X. When that one you drop, then Triple Vex. Fully.
Run it.
When you want you the sound of, if you can't listen, it can go off. The sound of. Hear me, I say, keep it represent to the fullest, and I mean, for the sound of. Monday to Friday, 1 to 3. On Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media. Mad.
Get them ready. Show them what beans do.
Okay, 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 okay. At the sound of Nationwide, 90 FM, 1 to 3 p.m. Lad.
They ain't believing us. God did.
What's up? It's Megan Sue, and you're listening to the sound off on Nationwide 90 FM.
Nah, malalai.
Sound off, Monday to Friday, on Nationwide, 90 FM. This is Benjamin. Give it to them, Zaga, Zen.
Oh, you mean?
All right.
Yo, you hear me, Cinnamon and Dexter, up, so you're listening to the sound off. 1 to 3, every day, on Nationwide. You know each other. Love.
The number one power mixer, DJ Jerome, the Shell Boss.
Sound off, Monday to Friday. 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 On Nationwide, 90 FM. This is Benjamin. Give it to them, Zaga, Zen. On Nationwide, 90 FM. This is Benjamin. Give it to them, Zaga, Zen.
Yeah.
Yes, 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 yes. It is April 9, 2024, and you are now in the entertainment zone. Yes, you are. 1 o'clock. And specifically, you know where you are, right? The Sound Off, because we hit things just right. We're here. We're here for you. So this is Karen Design Diva Booker alongside the magnanimous Mr. Triple X. And of course, the wonderful, the very entertaining, the Shell Boss himself, Mr. DJ Jerome.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So it's Wednesday. No, it's Tuesday. Why am I rushing the week? I am living one day at a time because you know what? Today, in somewhere around the world, it is National Mature Women's Day. Oh. Yeah, it certainly is. So because now I'm a woman of a certain age, I'm celebrating myself, as well as everybody else who are now in their auntie era, you know. Please celebrate you. Please take up space. Please be unapologetic. Please, please, please don't let anybody who, you know, has had enhancements make you feel bad about the natural aging process. Yes. You know, don't follow fashion. Be the fashion. You understand what I'm saying? And yes, ladies, just take up space and live in your wisdom, live in your discernment, live in your clarity, and live in all of the experience that has brought you thus far. Because guess what? We don't have unlimited life. If it's one thing that I have been saying for a while now, some of us act like we have unlimited life, you know, we don't. So, guess what? No, it is Tuesday. It is Tuesday already. And you know, after this, the week goes downhill from there, right? Because then we're into hump day and then that's it. So we have a ram-packed show for you today, as usual. And for all my people on YouTube, welcome, welcome to you. Yes, and if you are not on YouTube yet, Lord have mercy, again, may I beg you every day, run over to the Google App Store. Please download the Nationwide 90 FM Live app. Yes, subscribe. Engage, you know, and share the thing, and of course like it up so the algorithm will show us to everybody else, and then we will continue to enlarge our numbers. Yes, yes, yes. And for my ride along people, my day oneers, my people all over the place who are listening in barbershops, in government agencies, in boutiques, in, you know, hair salons, hey, thank you for sharing space with me and Triple in the Sound Off every day between Monday to Friday, of course, with the musical stylings of the one and only DJ Jerome. Yes. So
in the building.
Of course. So, you know, big show. Big show today. You know, we have Riff from the Headlines. We have Talk Your Mind. We have What's on Your Lunch Menu, the crowd favorite. So, you know, send in your things from now, because I really don't want to hear again, oh, I'm sending my food, I'm doing good. Send it in from now, 876-280-6629. After that, we're going to jump into the design studio. We're going to be talking about some colors today, because I realize from all of these things that people, no, primary colors. So I'm not even going to say secondary and tertiary. We kind of don't know it. And then after that, now me and Tripp are going to talk up with things again and again and again and again and again. All right. So I'm going to jump right into
an extra, extra. Read all about it.
It's ripped from the headlines.
Speaking of which, big headline. I want everybody to pay attention to Mr. Triple Darrell Cummings' ex hat. It is a piece of art.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Yes, it has.
Thank you. And thank you. And thank you.
People can't see.
Very, very much.
You know? See, right? It has a little thing. What's the name of that brand again? It's Babe. Yeah. Got a couple of those myself. The very nice designer. Love it. All right.
Afrinis.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Afrinis.
Okay. All right. From who? Huh? God bless you.
I don't even remember. Some people did send me some clothes one time. And something. What if I sit, man? I said, son.
No, but that's trending right now, so you need to wear that. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I just dig up me and dig up and say, yeah.
That's trending. Mm-hmm.
That's trending.
All right, talk about trending now. Let's see. So Scatter Burrell has now entered the chat. So dancehall producers Cordell Scatter Burrell's 21-year-old coolie dance juggling rhythm has been sampled by yet another American star. This time, multi-platinum songstress Kalani for her new track, After Hours. I am extremely grateful because I promised myself one day I need to sit down and count the amount of features Coolie Dance has had with international acts, and it has been quite successful. It is almost 25 years since that rhythm has been out, you know. So it's great to know that you can do work and it spans the test of time, Scatter told, of course, Dancehall Magazine. Released on April 4, After Hours is a lead single from Kehlani's upcoming fourth studio album. Scatter, who is credited as a songwriter in the new track, pointed out that Coolie Dance's ability to stand the test of time was another piece of evidence that authentic dancehall rhythms cannot be deemed dead or a relic of decades ago, as they have remained in demand and keep getting sampled over the years by some of the world's biggest megastars.
Scatter now stop make money for now. That is for sure.
Pocket long.
Him now stop make money for now. No time for now. You understand? And I just want him something. You understand me? I say, good music shall always stay true and shine true. You understand? So, big up to Scatter. Anytime the royalty check them, come remember me. Remember say me and Bridget, you know, just remember. You understand? That is it.
I really, really love it because, you know how it is. It's like, listen, you got to get your legacy down and people really have to start flying that flag and giving the credit where it is due. So, here's the thing now. Gangster ass, Munga. Honorable says his 2006 hit Flippin' Rhymes made him the pioneer of the trap sound within dancehall. Mm-hmm. And me bring trap boya. Me never name it, but me did just a trap, he recently told Negos Aymara, on the Aymara Nation podcast. A rap music me listen to, you know. A rap music are one of my biggest influences on R&B, which influenced the harmonic, melodious part of my writing. Produced by Don Corleone, Flipping Rhymes was a part of the high altitude rhythm, which also brought hits
high
such
altitude.
As Sean Paul Smoke and Rihanna's it Break It Off and voicemails Let's Dance to the Airwaves. All right, Munga.
Let's dance. All right, hold on.
All right, Mr.
See if
Munga.
Find a song and play one excerpt from it. Because see if I could show the people. I show Munga attacks still.
It's his time now. You know it's his time now, right?
Hold on. Razzy saying it's not trap.
Razzy
wait 1 second for me now, please. Play Munga's.
Okay.
Munga's
what is his time? Be relevant, Munga.
But
Duke,
the truth of the matter is this, you know. If I'm a Munga, I don't know. It's the Munga and the rebel. Turn it up a little bit there, Razzy. It's not fast. Hold on. All right.
My brain keeping rhymes, lift keep spitting lines, left hand keeping time, right hand gripping.
Then what is that, sir?
I don't really think this is trap for you, still.
Okay, it's what?
It's rapping, okay. But it's not trap.
Well, the man versatile.
It's more hip-hop than trap. You understand?
M versatile.
If you talk about trap, we have to talk about down here. We down here song name again. We down here. Down here to me, down here are the father of trap dancehall. To me. I won't tell you the name of the song still.
Agree. Right.
But Munga, Marietti, I know Marietti, but I don't think this is trap dancehall.
Yeah.
This is more rap. You understand? First of all, this way I do writers so rapping pan dancehall beats. Something that I do it. Dr. Oh. Evil.
Okay.
They do it from them time they talk.
Okay.
You understand? Whole heap of man did I do it. The way I do. Eh? Is it? Oh, Munga or left side.
Well, I left like side. It.
Alright. But big up to them people. I go Munga when I go say your contribution never valid and relevant. But I don't think that you can really claim trap dancehall. If I this year I go use. You understand? Because I don't think this is really trap dancehall still. But big up Munga
and
everybody.
But you know, to your irrelevance and so on, step into your space and take up a lot of it. You know what I mean? Hear this now. I'm telling you, let me tell you something. All right, Rihanna graces the cover of Interview Magazine. On Tuesday, April 9, Interview Magazine took to its official Instagram account to share a post revealing Rihanna as the cover star of its latest issue. In the shot, Riri poses in a black and white headdress or coif, typically worn by nuns. Additionally, Riri rocked an unbuttoned white top, blue eyeshadow, and sultry red lipstick. So there are lots and lots. I mean, so the internet is now ablaze. A lot of people are making comments, of course, because that's the place for it. And if you put yourself out there, you're gonna get backlash. So here it is now. When are we gonna stop tolerating the mockery of Christianity? One viewer. Another one. It's a no for me, and I'm not even that religious. Another one. We respect every religion except Christianity. All right, here's another. this is getting really tired. Out of all concepts, they decided on mocking Christianity. Super annoying. Get away from me with this. Another, the disrespect. Hashtag unbelievable. Hashtag mockery. Next, sexualizing a nun is nasty work. The people in the industry will tell us over and over again what they think of relationships with God and don't care what they do and who they disrespect.
Men, I think it is necessary still. This is very unnecessary to me. Not for Rihanna. If you're a little thirsty artist where I look clout or look attention, Rihanna don't need this for the attention. I mean, I said the reason for this, you understand, you have to understand, you know, whether or not you believe in Christianity, whether you believe in somebody's religion, you should not set and use the people's religion and make it into effigy. You understand me? I say, I don't think that this is have no farmer. Whether the magazine or not, you have to understand what this represents. You understand me? I say, Zine, this represents the women of the purest form within the Catholic religion. You understand me, I say? And then you are going to hypersexualize them, showing cleavage and all them something. The reason why them adorn a headdress and adorn the garment is because them are trying to remove the sexuality from them presence and thus have them as a vessel for Christ. You understand? They even practice abstinence. And to over-sexualize something or hypersexualize a pillar in the Catholic religion just for monetary gain, this is very low. This is tasteless. You understand me? I say, Zine, me not go around Rihanna as a Jamaican, she don't know better. You understand me? I say,
well, thank God she's not Jamaican, and we're not going to claim this on this side. I know we've claimed her already, and we've said, oh, Rihanna, we claim you. We're not going to claim you. We're going to throw you right back out there from where you came from, because this right now is crazy. This, and what I'm saying, when she came out with the Emperor's New Clothes, with the naked pregnancy thing tripping around all over the place, and people thought that was a trend, that is one thing. But when you are going to now do something like this and form agreements with folks who are not of God, that is another thing. And the thing is, in a triple, we have to understand that this woman has tremendous clout, tremendous influence, and people are watching her. So now everything she does, every single thing she does is now a thing. You know, so if we don't come out and put a stop to it, I mean, all right, she is now a national hero in her country. She's now a national hero in her country. You mean to tell me that management, anybody couldn't say to her, maybe this is not the best of decisions for you to make at this point. Maybe this is not the best of covers that you should do. You know, I'm not even going to get into the fact that you're a mother and you're a this. That is your personal situation. But when it comes to you being a public figure and then somebody who is now a national figure, a national hero in your country, and this is what you're saying that you can do, disgracing and just putting down the Christianity faith, because everybody who comes from the Caribbean, you know, everybody in Jamaica knows God. If you come from Jamaica, you know God. If you come from most of the Caribbean, you know God. So this is a willful situation where, you know, it is just a matter of disgrace. And I am sick and tired of people saying it's art. It is not art. This is an agreement with something of a very dark place. You hear these things come up every now and again, like, hey, listen, when these people become super popular and these mega stars, they form these agreements. You know, please, people, watch your children, watch who they are paying attention to, because sometimes they pay attention to people and things that they ought not to because of pop culture.
All right. Now, it has been brought to my attention from the comment section. I think Andre said, Triple, you oppose too much. No, you see, it's not that I oppose too much. You know, it's just that what I believe. I mean, I go say so. I just jump up and just say something because it is popular.
Say it now.
Huh?
Say it now.
What?
Triple's beliefs and my beliefs are not necessarily the beliefs of everybody. Right, that's why
it's
we're here.
That's what me believe.
That's where we're
first
here.
Of all, it also in the comment section, it said that the nun costume has been done before and rare. It's not
so?
The first. Not because it's done before. The superstar, the level of superstardom that Rihanna has, she does not need to do this.
No.
Razzie just brought to my attention that this was not her choice. This was the magazine or the person who booked her, this was the shoot that they offered. Rihanna is a billionaire. And every money I need for jumping. And every money I need for jump on. This was very unnecessary. This is tasteless. Whether it was done before, whoever do it before, this is tasteless. You have to understand, you have to respect other people's religion. It come like, remember the woman, what did God do the porn scene with in the hijab? And then something, and the entire country, the country did actually request them, as such name, Mia Khalifa, them did request them for extradite her to. Mm-hmm. What country name with them did want them extra if you got try her because of you know the Middle East, them did want try her over there, them did want extradite her, then it's a legal proceeding for extradite her over there because she actually used a real hijab because she has Muslim parentage and she used a real hijab in a
sudden people that take them and them did want to
carry her over there for stone her.
Them still stone, you know. Yeah. Yes, they still stone you
whether
there.
Or not it is archaic, whether or not you have to remember, respect people's religions, respect people's belief. You understand? Zine, we have to understand that we have to hold certain and certain things. There, you can't just look upon people's religion and just use it for us to monetize it and just make it look. It's ridiculous. It come like somebody are coming in your house and come take a crap in the middle of your living room. That is huge. That is disrespect.
But the thing about it, Triple, if when I'm looking at the comments now in our comments, right, and I'm seeing Karen, stop sounding so melodramatic. Somebody even told me to shut up and go to the next story. You know, we have one person saying it's beautiful. Another one says, y'all put too much pressure on celebrities. Another one says, Karen, we love you, but speak for yourself. It's not every Jamaican know God.
Well, are not every Jamaican know God. It's not about knowing
it's
God.
It's not. Thank you.
You know that this is the symbol. There's nobody in the world right now. We don't know what the symbolism of this is. Yeah. Nobody don't know. Whether or not you say it look good, or it look sexy, or it that, irrespective of that. And everything will look good for eat, supposed to eat. You understand me? I say, when I need to understand this.
Wow.
See, now this is our views. I understand say people now agree totally, but I understand and I appreciate the fact that that's your views. But in my view, which will not be swayed based on public or popular culture, this is distasteful. And in my opinion, my poor opinion, my broke pocket opinion, Rihanna never did need for this. She is a national hero.
Mm-hmm. And also
for Barbados. You understand? Barbados is a Christian nation as well.
Let's put that in.
You understand? We need to understand what the symbolism of this is. You see, if this was done by an up-and-coming artist, we could have overlooked it. Because the responsibility, social responsibility of that up-and-coming artist is not as much as Rihanna. We keep on us about, we must place this amount of energy on celebrities. This woman is one of the most influential persons in the entire world.
And that's exactly whether or not what we're trying to believe say. It or not. So she has tremendous influence and tremendous clout. Now, yes, we're not saying that everybody should be a role model, but when you have reached that pinnacle, you really do have some sense of responsibility toward the people who are coming up. You know what I'm saying? We're not saying, oh, you're a role model, you're a role model, but you need to make better choices, better decisions.
Here
you know, and this is not because, we're going to
take a quick break. And you'll come back with
talk up your
talk
mind.
Your mind.
Talk up your mind.
It's time for a new look.
And high time to get serious about protecting our home and investment.
It's time to choose BH Paints with over 60 years experience in quality paint finishes. Their products are superior and long-lasting.
Time to check them out.
Ask about BH Paint's 100% Acrylic Ultima Plus paint and primer in one. Experience rich colors with advanced UV and mildew-resistant technologies, independently tested by experts. What are you waiting for? Visit a BH Paint's Color Center today.
Nationwide 90FM, the station for the very latest in news and current affairs, will broadcast live from the JPS Foundation Skills Training and Mentorship Program launch for unattached youth. On Tuesday, April 9, tune in to Cliff Hughes Online as they reveal the activities for the program this year. Hear from representatives from the Jamaica Public Service and the Excelsior Community College. You don't want to miss...
Come join us outside with Pepita every Saturday from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. right here on Nationwide 90 FM. We bring you the views, the news, and
and we'll be cruising all around Jamaica.
Hey, surprise them with a bang.
For the hot spots, raindrop sunshine, we'll be there. Don't diss it, don't miss it. Outside with Pepita.
Yeah, Frost, may I chat my mind by now? Hey, yeah. May I chat my mind by now? Hey, I'm in a business. May I do things? Rough up, we no care who fix, 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 we no care.
What you think? What you feel? Talk your mind.
I just have one more thing to add, one more little thing. And of course, you know that my views, you know, are not necessarily the views of Nationwide. It's my views and my views alone. Mm-hmm. And I stand by it. OK, we live in a society now where, you know, wrong is wrong. Right is wrong is blurred by the amount of time and the amount of times people see it. So if something is wrong, mm-hmm. right, all of a sudden it becomes right because it has been done before. Or it becomes right because of who is doing it. Or it becomes right because we have this skewed impression as to what our values are and so on. Let me tell you something. Wrong is wrong. It's not a suggestion. It is not something that we can argue about unless you're in a court of law and it's like whoever is prove them case is whatever the case. But, you know, but wrong is wrong, right is right, no matter who does it and no matter how much time passes.
All right, Karen, let us agree to disagree with,
sure.
With the audience, and we're moving right along.
We're going to move along.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, now, here we are going on. Talking about agreeing to disagree. Now, there are some polarizing figures in Jamaican.
My best friend.
Social media. There is one, Mr. Tolax, who is mm-hmm. very, very polarizing. There is one, Mr. Futa Hype, mm-hmm. who is extremely polarizing
mm-hmm.
and probably one of the most polarizing figures in today's social media sphere is the Don.
Pretty.
The pretty one.
The pretty one.
Yeah, the pretty Don.
Best friend in my head.
You understand? Mm-hmm. No. A lot of things that this young lady says, our young man.
No, she's not switching.
No.
Well,
no. This young person, this young person, this young individual mm-hmm. states are sometimes very, like all the time, our delivery is very, very harsh.
And raw.
To be honest, there's a lot of times that I do agree with her. There's sometimes that me not really too agree with what she has said, not only does the delivery, but what it is that she's saying for most times, most parts is what everybody's thinking. And it is common opinion, but her mode of delivery is very, very distasteful.
So,
you understand?
For backstory, guys, and because she's friend in my head, right? And I enjoy her. I enjoy her a little bit too much with my little, you know, ways. You know me, right? But the thing is, she's a guilty pleasure for me.
Mm-hmm.
She sits by the side of her home or some home, a dwelling, in a chair. And she has this book. And God knows, if you are in that book, your goose cook. You understand? So she comes every day and she has this.
My goose not cook at 2 times. I go in there. And
I do. Your goose not cook. So she sits at the side of her home in this chair. And she has her book, like a spiral stenographer's notebook, you know? And she has these names in there. And then she says, okay, it's your turn today. As a matter of fact, did you see the skit once when somebody teeth our chair? Run
yeah.
Out of the chair? That was really funny.
Slick white line. Well, all right, you want me. You want me now. So.
So what's, is it up?
Good, no.
Oh, no, okay, all right.
So, make us set Sangi a little backstory now.
Go ahead.
In our Gwan now.
Because
mm-hmm. we have a video, but it's having problems to download. So, ladies and gentlemen, you know the gentleman that came to Jamaica over the weekend for a carnival? Mm-hmm. A young man.
A whole group.
Young man and his team came. Kai Sinat and his whole team of streamers. So, the persons who are mature.
Yes, because it's national mature woman day, you know.
Yeah,
mature.
The women that are, the people out there who are more mature who don't understand what streaming is. Streaming is basically
when I reach
going
this,
on
I
a social media. Well, I know, we're on a social media platform and you put out your views or you play games or whatever it is that you do and you do it for public consumption.
Right.
You understand? Mm-hmm. So doing that is public consumption. It's for public consumption.
Okay.
So the young man is a streamer.
Okay.
No.
Mention his nationality, please.
He's American.
But
he is American of Trinidadian parentage. Mm-hmm. And Trinidadian, I think, Haitian parentage.
Okay.
So, yeah. So he's actually genetically a Caribbean expat.
Yeah, man.
Trinidad, yeah, man. Yeah, his father is from, yet his mother is from Trinidad.
Okay. Right.
So he is...
out of many one.
Yeah, a Caribbean expat. Mm. Now, he recently visited Jamaica. Because he visits many countries and he participates in their culture. And he's just a very, very energetic person. Mm-hmm. You understand? He's extremely energetic and is, in a Jamaican term, what I call it, vulgar.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, vulgar.
Yeah, man.
But not in a distasteful way or in a nasty way. His vulgarity is...
in enough way.
It's like a guilty pleasure. You understand? It's like kind of cringy. Kind of cringy, but it's still fun to watch. Mm-hmm. You understand me? I said that's what gives him his view. Yeah, his viewability. Now, when he came to Jamaica, he visited several places.
Mm. And he came to Jamaica for what?
He came to Jamaica for a carnival.
Okay, all right.
You understand?
Because remember, you know, we have really mature people in Africa.
Yeah. So he went to several places, Jamaican hotspots, and he was participating in the culture, the food. He went downtown. Mm-hmm. He went to the market. He went to the arcade. He went to a lot of the places that... went to KFC. He really and truly tried to engulf himself in the Jamaican culture that is not marketed. Mm-hmm. You understand me, I say? Mm-hmm. The parts of Jamaica that is not marketed. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. So, then that's not what most celebrities, when they come to Jamaica, them do the touristy things and them get a official tour guide to take them to certain and certain places. He linked up with other streamers, other vloggers, other YouTubers, other TikTokers, and they just show him the Jamaican, the unseen Jamaica.
Right.
You understand me? I say, or the unpromoted Jamaica. And he went and and to me, honestly, I saw most of the videos and it seemed raw, a little bit theatric.
But it's part of the pop culture.
Yeah.
That's part of his appeal.
Yeah.
So I would call that now roots tourism.
Yeah. All right.
All right.
So what he did was he shined a light on Jamaica, in a part of Jamaica that is normally not illuminated. You understand? And a lot of persons would actually visit Jamaica for that, because he has a huge, when we say huge, we're talking about huge following. When we talk about the influence of Rihanna, this gentleman is probably now in his age demographic more influential than even a Rihanna, than a Beyonce. You understand me? I say, than a Kim Kardashian. This is probably the most influential person of this generation, this young man. A lot of persons don't know, because probably the first time I see him, just come to Jamaica, kind of in that sphere, but he is the most influential person in that sphere. Every artist in America, every A-grade artist in Jamaica, in America, in the world, when they have new projects to put out, they actually
them check him.
Go on his stream.
Mm-hmm. Them check him.
To do that. They go over there to get his, them pay like millions of dollars, like $2 million, $3 million to go on his streams. Mm-hmm. For go pan theme stream just to get his fan base to see that they have new music coming out. We good now? Jereen? Ready now?
You're ready now.
So,
okay, all right. So.
Now, Pretty Dan, being Pretty Dan and being the person who she is, she gave her commentary on the Kai situation in Jamaica. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you are at home, if you are on YouTube, have a look. If you are listening on the radio, please have a listen to what Pretty Dan had to say.
Mm-hmm. One thing me have to tell you.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
you see how no over there going over Kai? Mm-hmm. Nobody boy and no going over Kai like that. You hear me tell you? No? You see, who no don't at Jamaica feel like I say, no see one nowadays Michael Jackson come down there too, no bro? That is not the case. This little man play a video game, and in getting local gift them and getting streaming rare off of YouTube like everybody else, me generally. You understand me? I deal with the way how the whole of the dung they are behave like Michael Jackson. This every scroll, me scroll from a timeline. You know how much people at Jamaica don't know, but because of the dung they are run up and down and a swell a man on the mouth. So who don't make Jamaica feel like I said them your man who own one baseball team in America, or who own one NBA team, or this your man is spectacular. You know how much people in America pass Kai for that street? People in America don't behave like that over Kai Jamaica. Who not alone give Kai that feeling the way I have right you now. Who no make who no too frightened over a Russian him start to come up there and bring two little people from foreign. Who no swear things that them your kind of people are some kind of billionaire. Them are some kind of engineer. Who no be happy? Jamaica who no alone. Missy run back. Jesus Christ, you don't think of the nowadays Selassie. Eh? What you mean not you? Never see nobody run up and down so back in America unless you happen to one place and give away some things. Who do not bottle, bro? Who do not bother with that, bro? So you see this man you go in a basketball game and sit on courtside. I can buy courtside seat and go sit down there with the celebrity.
All right. Okay. Okay.
I would love for you to do so and take me with you, pretty. Take me with you.
No.
All right. You go and then I go.
I am not going to say that. You can't buy a courtside seat. But this gentleman doesn't buy courtside seats. He is invited by the teams to come sit courtside for free. This man literally was also invited to the NBA All-Star Weekend. He was the host, one of the hosts for NBA All-Star Weekend. He was even used in the NBA dunk competition for All-Star Weekend. This young man, 2 years ago, had a meet and greet in Manhattan, in a New York. The same foreigner, she said, nobody not run him down. And when the man had the meet and greet in a New York, they had to literally lock down. They had to call in the National Guard because Manhattan itself had to shut down on a Thursday. This was a Thursday. Manhattan, the whole entire city of New York had to shut down. They had to send the New York NYPD had to send a helicopter to airlift him out of New York City. They were even planning to charge him.
Yes.
Triple.
For inciting a riot, all the man was having was a meet and greet. People from, because he is from Brooklyn. All I know, he is from Brooklyn, New York, and he live in Atlanta. And he had a meet and greet in Manhattan. And the entire city of Manhattan, the entire part of Manhattan had to close down. The entire place had to close down for almost 14 hours. You know why it takes for New York shut down? For New York, first of all, honestly, me personally believe, say, Jamaicans never did really go on as frightened as how me feel like they never go on. One thing about Jamaican, you know, we not frightened, you know.
We not frightened.
So not because you see my video that, because if it was under normal circumstances, him couldn't walk downtown. Remember, I'm going to Africa, you know. Him does come from Nigeria, you know. I want him go Nigeria. And Nigeria gone, I'm go over there. Some place Africa, I'm go over
Africa.
There.
West Africa.
I want him over there, you know. Them literally have to shut down one part of the city over where I'm going Africa,
say,
you know.
Yeah, but me as a triple, you're not afraid pretty than put in our beating book.
No, he wasn't there twice. It's fine. It would be good.
He was in there.
You're afraid pretty. I'm going there two times already. No business. Like, brother, first of all, what can you honestly say about me that I haven't said about myself? Like, honestly, yeah. You can't afraid of people, brother. We're not going to make nobody because of them bullies in them.
True.
Them stop it from talking. True. That's the truth, fam.
But what may I say still?
Yes.
That video is some kind of bad man from Pretty Dan. I don't like all this.
But that's like, her. That's her.
Like, the young man came to Jamaica
right.
to enjoy himself. Mm-hmm. You know, him put Jamaica up on a pedestal. Him say he love Jamaica and want to come experience the thing. And then the man come experience the thing. Like, why y'all are trying to beat? Why she try to beat him?
Because that's what she does.
For welcome him in.
That's what she does. You have to understand, Pretty Dawn, this is her commentary. Mm. She has to make sure that she finds something or an angle that she can get at you at. Whether it's, and remember, that's her opinion. You understand? So it's all opinion. There's nothing based in science. There's nothing based in fact. That is all Pretty Dawn's. And that is her platform. Just like this guy here now raised himself up from bootstraps, found an angle that people like, and he really exploited that, and now he is where he is. So I'm not mad at him. I am not. I just want some Jamaicans to get to where he is as well. I guys can see, judging by what I saw on TikTok all over the weekend, Swiss Lee not too far off, because them did love him too. And what's your name? Rebel. And Rebel, you know what I'm saying? So therefore, there is a whole, and let me tell you something, mature people, because you know it's mature people day. Let us not bash these young people. It is their time. Let them do what they're doing. Let them go ahead. It is their time. Social media is their platform. Well, everybody else's platform. We know that because the mature people are saying yes. Mm. But social media, they have found a way. Right? Without up the market advertising like TV and radio and whatever. They have found a way to capitalize on that for their gain. Nothing.
Somebody said, what is Pretty Dance claim to fame?
Chat people.
Yeah. Roasting. And the truth of the matter is, I'm not gonna tell you.
I love it.
I'm gonna tell you the truth.
Chat people.
I want my guilty pleasure them. I love watching them.
Yes.
You understand, because it is funny.
It is
a guilty pleasure. It is very distasteful, a lot of it.
Exactly.
Yeah, but a lot of things, them, it is funny. You understand?
And people would say that I could be a bit hypocritical because I'm listening to all this foul language and I call myself a Christian. But then again, I don't live in a bubble.
And the truth is, she has brought back something that is missing from our society. Shame. Yeah. You see, shame. My aunt me telling her, shame is a wonderful thing.
A healthy dose.
A healthy dose of shame is wonderful, you know. Pretty Dan has made people, make enough of them artists here, go back on them P's and Q's. Make enough of them social media, go back on them P's and Q's. Because enough of the foolishness of them feel like they would have get away with. She said, Sanji, call it out. No matter how distasteful they might think that it is, she call them out.
No.
You understand me? I say, the truth of the matter is, yes, in this case here, she rang, and fully rang. Because the truth of the matter is, nobody never run down Kai. Kai are the first. I must say, truly, because security alone, never walk up and down. Nobody now, the most somebody want, I want a little picture. Nobody not even already. Nobody, Jamaican people are the most. You see, Jamaican people, them just want to sit and cut. Now, Jamaican people not going to rub nobody and map nobody on them thing. You see, Jamaican, I want the most careful, careless, laser-feric type of person when it comes to star and celebrity. Nobody no more than we. We couldn't have push one car, couldn't have sell bag juice. The man, if Beyonce can't turn upside with the most, he say, oh, Beyonce, big up yourself.
You know why that is? Because we don't like to think that somebody else is higher in hierarchy
don't
than
jungle.
They are. You understand? That, you know, did you know that? It's because we don't want somebody to think that them higher than
them
we.
Them no more than we.
Exactly, and that is the premise behind it. That is why we are so disruptive. That's why we have so much. That's why when we go across the world, people look at us like them things. Them something else, man. Why them affair go and say, yes, it's that edge that we have because whatever tribe them import, them bring us from in Africa. Well, we must have been kings and queens.
Well, and I saw Maria say, hello, look at Uno. What is trash to one is treasure to another man.
Yeah.
Rihanna was just distasteful. Yes, Rihanna is distasteful. Yes, Pretty Dan is distasteful. But are you comparing Rihanna to Pretty Dan? Like really?
Like really?
Rihanna to Pretty Dan. Rihanna is a national hero.
Yeah.
You understand? Pretty Dan is a national scourge. You understand? So you can't compare the two. You understand? No, certain things here, it come like you say. You expect the person where work as a janitor at the hospital, if he can do the same type of open heart surgery as the cardiologist.
You know, sometimes people,
it's
you know,
two different things you can't expect.
And that kind of comparison you call apples and oranges. You understand what I'm saying? Whoever you want to call the apple, whoever you want to call the orange. If you get to know who Pretty Dawn is, you will see that she is in a class
of
by
her
herself. Nobody can compare to she. And she has no, as Kai, as Rihanna, as all of them.
She's providing custodial services for the entertainment industry. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick commercial break. I'm going to come back to what's on your lunch menu. The number to send you the food is 280-6629. Watch out, Pretty Dan, I go rub out Karen tomorrow.
Lord have mercy.
It's time for a new look.
and high time to get serious about protecting our home and investment.
It's time to choose BH Paints with over 60 years experience in quality paint finishes. Their products are superior and long-lasting.
Time to check them out.
Ask about BH Paints 100% Acrylic Ultima Plus paint and primer in one. Experience rich colors with advanced UV and mildew-resistant technologies, independently tested by experts. What are you waiting for? Visit a BH Paints Color Center today.
You've sat and made your list of priorities, must-haves and must-be's for a potential partner. But that was then. This is now, and according to the rules of relationships, being over 30 makes many women reevaluate their possibilities, position, and potential to find the ideal person. How easy is it to make it happen as time passes? Are the assets as valuable, or the pickings are now diminishing in returns? Why should a woman settle, or should she just settle down with the available aspirant? Join me, Rodney Campbell, every Tuesday from 9 to 10:30 p.m. for Affairs of the Heart, right here on Nationwide 90 FM. This Tuesday's topic, after 30 and dating, should women increase their standards or lower their expectations?
Brought to you by SuperMed Pharmacy. Super happy, super healthy, SuperMed.
Tune in to Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media. Stay ahead of the curve with our cutting-edge reporting and accurate breaking news coverage.
We are having an earthquake. Oh, God.
Hear it here first on Nationwide 90 FM.
Is that really clip you started?
Tune in, turn up the volume, and listen. We bring a mix of news, entertainment, and sports to your lives.
Nationwide 90 FM's live and continuous coverage of the World Championships in Budapest, Hungary.
News and discussions week mornings.
Coming up in the news at 6 for this morning.
Entertainment in the afternoons, then news again in the evenings.
Nationwide news at this hour, fired.
Also, tune in to the entertainment and sports shows in the nights and on the weekends.
It is Boyettings After Dark Retro on Nationwide 90 FM.
Everything is news, from current affairs and entertainment to sports, business, and other categories.
Nationwide 90 FM. This is Beanie Man. Give it to them. Zaga, Zen.
From every whisper to every commotion.
That's rubbish. The KSAMC cannot investigate itself.
Was Click News really talking like that?
Every news story unfolds here first at Nationwide 90 FM, the new revolution in media. Every sound is a story, and every story we share is news.
People, me have something to tell you now. A long, long time me a wait. But if the time is right, time is now. I'ma turn this stove down low and just pull the windows open. I'm in the mood, so me not go spoil it. Bet you I go warm me cook again. Saying, ooh, it's been a long, long time. I'm cooking some ashy for you, girl. But it seems like you never like rice. So I'm gonna get some flour first. And I want to give you some good.
It's lunchtime! What's on your lunch menu?
So, people, I want to see a food time now. You understand? And here we are going now. Before we even put up this, people, may I be going to please, I choose them. Please. Make it sit there look good. Yesterday was great. Monday was great.
Monday was great.
Whole heap of fish, you understand?
Seafood. It was beautiful. Tuesday,
make something them look good. You understand?
Yes.
Zane, thank you very much.
Also, you ready? Guys have an opportunity right now. We have so many people on the live. And you mean to tell me, like up the thing right now, no man? Just like it up. Okay, so what is this now? This is from our favorite place.
Pringles and the whole Portmore massive always lacking big up on ourselves. Become a friend in front of Portland. So far out of Portland, man.
Ingles.
You understand? Before the summer come. Now, here we are going on. Ready? What was this? This is roast Dr. Fish with festival garden salad with like a ranch sauce that you say on your garden salad.
A ranch on the side and festival.
All right.
Now this is one time that I would have preferred for the roast fish to be covered with the cage, you know, with all kind of things on the roast fish. I don't know why roast fish have to look so.
Because roast fish is not really a sauced fish, and you know, I really use it because it's open fire cooked fish.
You understand?
You understand me?
But don't you put it in foil?
Me personally, me love roast fish, and I'm a favorite type of fish. My favorite type of fish.
But you can put it in foil at least, so it not look so.
No man, cause this not roast in a foil. You know, this roast pan zinc. You know.
Right, that's what I'm saying. So, but you could put it in the foil, so therefore you get the same kind of flavor.
No, it is the way because the roast now are the charredness them want.
Yeah.
For the zinc, cause the zinc seasoning. You know. It's like a wok. Like how you season a wok.
Yeah, like how you do jerk, like authentic jerk. Yeah. You have the whole thing or whatever.
Yeah.
Right.
But this, I'm gonna give this. Because, and I'm a favorite. It look good still. I'm going to give this one 9. Festival, let me go on.
8.5 for you guys. 8.5 for you guys. Next time, give me where's something
Jero?
More garnish.
Well, White Sun, send this in.
Yeah, it's White Sun. See that?
Rocky Pine, big up on yourself. Where you say, Jerome?
Rosin says 6.
Need that 9.
6.
9. Yes. 9 from Jerome as well.
That's not so nice. 5.
Next up.
New says she'll eat the festival and the vegetables. Oh, what is this? What? Ooh, this looks very nice.
This name cook a yard.
A whole heap
this
of
name
food.
Cook
this
a yard.
This name cook for triple because only triple one. This half of this would be for me, and then I don't want the right. As a matter of fact, yeah.
This is
I wouldn't want the
right. Pork leg.
Stewed pork leg. Okay.
And a leg bone. This Mexico. This cook
for
bean in it.
Yeah.
Carrot in it.
Mm-hmm.
Irish in it.
Mm-hmm.
Wally pa rice. Wally pa meat. You understand?
This and you could eat this off in one sitting.
People, once upon a time.
Oh, so you could eat,
time,
you can't eat this now.
I'm mash off all plate big.
Once upon a time, as what,
when I mash this up and go back for
and more. What was this point in time when you would in once, like you not like last week, you never say you would mash up this and more.
No.
You can't eat all of this.
Let me tell you why I couldn't. You say rice is sitting heavy in your gut, you know. Mm-hmm. You see if I did like dumpling and then sitting there. Dumpling. If this amount of dumpling take up less space near more than near too much than rice. Rice are sitting with heavy, you know.
Yeah.
You see rice ask any you see curving people not really too like rice, cause rice top from eat. Amount of food you want. Cause you see rice are sitting with good on in your gut and
you know
sit down down there, man. You understand? Heavy up, you know, you have to bust your belt and lie down on your back, you know, and call somebody to draw for and comb your gut, you know.
Oh, my move, you know. God.
You have to lean and
this
twist and stretch.
This is too much.
When you don't eat all this plate of rice, you know, cut all some belch, you know, and you have to mind your belch, because you belch and vomit, you know.
So people who are riding around, it really looks great. It looks really, really good. As you say, is what kind of pork again?
It's a pork leg bone.
Pork leg, but what? How is it done? It's stewed?
It's stewed. Stewed
okay.
Pork
so
leg
half
bone.
The plate?
Literally half.
Is meat, and half the plate is white rice.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And it has a good color. It has great texture. It looks great. But, you know.
Alec, big up yourself. I'm going to give you a 10 for this.
Alec, you. Yeah,
I'm going to give you
a 10
for this.
It could feed a village. Yeah, it could feed a village.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Jerome, what you say?
Eat.
8 because of pork. I mean, no German really name pork.
Yeah.
Still,
yeah.
I
give it a 9 because it look good. I
it
don't eat pork.
Good. Next up.
What are this? Could you just zoom it up a little bit, please? Come on, that's a triple blind. And me can't see.
Brown stew fish with rice and peas brown and mixed vegetable. This does look chaka-chaka to me still.
Jesus. We know the plate. We know this place.
A sauce boss is South America, man.
Sauce boss, right. This is not Jamaican. Okay.
Sauce boss look like he eat already and go full back a plate, you know.
Yes, looks
this look like a second road, you know. Mm-hmm. This not look like that plate look too nasty and too full.
Mm-hmm.
If it look like somebody does eat out of that. It's our brown stew fish and inside, right? Brown stew fish and rice and peas.
Yeah.
I will have a mixed vegetable.
And some planting in there. There's a planting up there. So planting, don't cut the way you
I second
like
serving it. This, that, yeah, that food here. That food here. A man cook that food here.
Clearly,
I will put this.
Clearly, it
may
tastes
I give this
good.
One 8.
It must taste yeah, good. New said placa placa. What is placa placa? Shanique said messy. But
placa placa
mean
messy,
food
messy, chaka chaka.
Yeah.
That food, as me tell you, if you see that plate of food, you know, it's the first serving this. He eat half and in belly never full and then go fling back some more
back
food
some
from
more.
This. That food then a serve, then. Brother. A pile on food, this, bro. A pile on. This a food then a serve. This is no way you serve, give nobody for heat. This is just in go back a pot. Him literally go back a pot for this, brother.
This
are
oh
this are heights of craveness. Sauce mass big up yourself. This are heights of craveness. This is not presentable, none at all. Mood sending this a plate of food, yeah. They have food for me, not that.
Yeah, look what Leroy is playing dirty with. No, but yeah, Leroy agrees. He said, play it dirty with gravy, yes.
Yeah. Yes. I tell you too, this is a food, this is a type of food you eat.
Rosalind.
Late night eating them, when you're craving.
Rosalind said, five, this favor hug food. This oh, food, no.
Me am on the TV light, man. This is a food that I have no farmer presentation food.
Patrick, you can't give it 3. You have to give it at least 5.
Sauce boss, now no man has still there. Now the
sauce boss, okay.
I'll give him a 8 to the car. It looks like it tastes good. Don't
be, that's what I'm saying. It tastes good.
Presentation awful.
It tastes good.
But it looks like it tastes good.
It tastes good. It tastes good. It tastes good. Sauce boss, are you that? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Shelly, I'm saying, I'm not great in that mess.
You know, it's been out of
oh my God, Leroy said, "Let's not." Oh,
said, "Sass boss want to lick it and belly."
Look at this. This look like breadfruit.
I Jerome, this man. Me nah ask.
Yeah, me nah.
How about this? Curry goat.
Curry goat
with roast breadfruit.
With roast breadfruit. Little bit of carrot right there. It looks good.
A curry chicken.
Curry chicken.
Curry chicken and roast breadfruit.
All right. All right.
A dead yard food, this. A dead yard food, this man.
Oh, yeah, you're my curry chicken.
No, man, a dead yard food, this man. I ask you. No, man. Playing there.
No.
A dead yard food, let me tell you something.
Nice for breakfast.
This
is
a beautiful lunch. Breakfast? Oh, yes, my God.
Man.
This is lovely. Hello. For lunch.
For the people that come from country. You see, I got a dead yard and them are dig, like, them are keep a grave digging and then sitting there.
Then a curry chicken, then give?
Curry chicken, yeah, because you know what?
White rice.
Listen, man. No, man, anything. You say grave digging, remember, say I have to clear up a place, you know. I'm most of them bird people near breadfruit tree, you know. So you see in time, any breadfruit where they are grown, then fling that in a fire.
Where does Tripper get these when things from?
People, if I lie, me I tell. People on YouTube and TikTok, if I lie, me I tell.
Tripper say, most time, then bury them next to breadfruit tree.
Breadfruit tree. Me I tell, I don't know why.
So every burial ground, our breadfruit tree.
Breadfruit tree, when I go grave digging. You go grave digging in our country.
As of tomorrow, every time we look at the burial ground, we have to go look to and find the breadfruit tree.
Yeah, we're family yard. Family yard. Always near a breadfruit tree. It's either a breadfruit tree round there. I want banana walk. May I tell you?
No, the banana I choose.
Banana walk or breadfruit tree. So you see in time, grave digging a guan.
They want you to zoom it up.
Them do the zoom it up. When they do the clearing of the land. When you clear the land.
Yeah.
You see when they clear land.
Oh, look at that.
Near means normally guan. Yeah. You don't cook goat a grave digging.
No, sir.
Goat and nine night
goat
and funeral.
Nine and funeral. Exactly.
So you
so
see
I get
chicken
that.
Them. Chicken. Can I remember say if what if somebody take part in a church, like somebody went dead in a church, like one long time church goer, or deacon is standing sitting there.
Yeah.
If people them were part of a church, where raise fall, I go send fall come and then sitting there. Them I go send poor come for nine night. But you see fall, I will get enough from early.
From grave digging.
You get
digging.
Fall from grave digging.
Grave digging.
So you see, them I go curry fall. And them I got brown stew fall. And you see, when they do the clearing and the breadfruit tree there, then fling breadfruit in a fire.
Okay.
Then cook rice too, you know.
Yeah.
Roast breadfruit I got there.
Yeah.
And curry chicken. So me tell you so this dead yard
the
food.
The rice for make sure say it fill up your belly. I so. But let me tell but this is not dead yard for today.
Still.
This is somebody's lunch and it looks really good.
See the people them there. See Rick the cynic say at Triple X are real meds.
Country.
You understand? Real meds. See somebody said Gene Seller said true. Chicken soup that dried up. For real, me not gonna go around here, brother. People them from country, no come in for me, please. Cause you see them town people, they don't know nothing.
We don't need
member
to.
Member say, Unu na no way for bury people over Medarisa over Dove Catalonia no bury people. Unu na no yard up here, no can burn nowhere. Nobody no. So no know nothing.
It's alright.
No
it's okay. When
you dead, when you dead and them bury no people forgotten. Forgotten no. And
no,
people walk down the stone.
No, forget we were going. Them going go over there and say okay.
JP said, name is Banana Chips. 20% more chips seed than the banana left on ground.
The time by JP said, Mary's Banana Chips is.
It is 2:01 p.m. in the afternoon.
When me dead, everybody going come and them going remember me and them going say, here lies the greatest woman ever. And no breadfruit tree now.
Any adult got a bird, nobody now remember ya. You see that same stone where them put them on TV and sunny off and carve you out and
sell it.
And sell it back. You can't tell me. That's it.
Share ya.
Thank
see the woman.
Father God
see
me, fit me father of land of country and my grand people them. Me have different places to go bury. Thank you, Jesus. Cause if I did over dove cat, we'd have to go bury and made a rest.
No, no, go on a dove cat.
Bada
I
dead.
Will not be going
no,
to.
Wouldn't bother dead.
I will be spread on the ocean, and I you know, and I will you know I will bless everybody.
May I give this one 10 out of 10? Cause I know this tastes good.
Most.
Cause I know for a fact, so our whole man cook that food here.
an old man. No. That is how old man cook that food.
No,
that is how old man cook. Yes, you can
gravy,
see. Look,
you
look,
know what?
Look,
at how, food.
Look at how it just
next,
balance
please.
And nice.
Next,
how does a woman cook this?
Next, please.
A nice, plump, beautiful
May
granny.
I get one
a how mature woman cook that food. Now, Leroy, I must Leroy send. Leroy, you send the scene?
How are these? Ajayas. Big up on the screen.
I have no idea. And look, Lord have mercy, Jesus.
We go. This is Denny's, and Denny say that one name eat what you say first.
Denny's, what kind of sandwich is that?
Why yummy coconut roll? A coconut roll, right?
Coconut roll, yeah.
It's a coconut roll, right? Yeah. Our Malta. I want to talk this
no, but I am most interested in what's in that bottle right there and the combination of everything. What's going on?
Somebody read this to me, please.
What's going on?
What is it, Jerry? In the bottle.
Hold on, let me see if I can get it up. My screen just died. This looks like something in anticipation for later.
Turn a motivated roots.
Yeah,
motivated. I don't even know what they are. First, me, I say that.
Yeah, this looks like something that is new. You know.
But you may big up on yourself. That you said a coconut roll there. Me, I tell you.
Bad.
Yeah, what said it warm? Fling it in a microwave and make your bag swell. Bad.
Hold on.
We know 400 calories by itself. We know that it's a lot of calories. We're not talking about the calories, Razzie. We don't eat them things up on a regular. Sometimes you have to invite little happiness into your stomach and don't watch the calories. You understand? Bill.
No.
Jesus.
Invite, no,
God go with you now, Karen.
Yes.
Let me tell you something.
Motivated something. See the word of mercy. Yeah. I'm trying.
She don't read it already. Motivated.
Motivated
her roots,
what?
Man.
What is
anyway,
this?
Anyway, I am going to give this because it's a stopper gap. I'm not going to give no more than 6 for this. Don't bother even I feel like you're coming over here. Enough up yourself.
What do you mean don't give
a stopper gap?
7.5.
You're generous.
Of course.
What you say, Jerome?
Power to the people.
You have 7 too. Well, that's 6 from me. Come again.
Oh, Lorks, what is this?
No, somebody I got bossy today.
This is Vanessa. Who is this? Is this Vanessa?
Pick up this one, please.
The clean plate?
Van. Hey, guess our. Just guess our.
Oh.
Look on it and tell me our. People in the comment section, guess is what?
It's not pork? No.
Guess is what?
It's tin pork.
Oi, Kuna man Jerome?
Oh, sorry. Oh, okay, so Jerome just gave it to me. He says tin mackerel.
Remember, she not really used today's thing, you know? She not used today's thing, you know?
I was thinking it's pork.
You understand?
That is tin mackerel?
First of all, this is not tin mackerel.
It's what?
This is tin macraw.
Yeah,
with the oxtail. Or fish fillet and tomato sauce.
Yes,
sauce.
Yeah, it's a 10 plus me.
This is a 10 out of 10 out of 10.
So this would have 10. So this would be mackerel input in tomato sauce?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, you say mackerel bossy. Look on this if vegetable to the side, the what tomato, the cucumber, the pear, the lettuce, look on the rice. Hey, why you know bossy. if
people who are riding along, you are missing out
may
on
I tell
in your
man,
life.
I,
you understand what
bossy.
I'm saying? This is when nice. I tell you about the green
presentation.
Of the broccoli is bright. Then we talk about the avocado. Then of course she has a layered thing. As you know, is Vanessa. Whenever you see Vanessa's layering of the cucumber and the tomato and everything is fresh vegetables. There's nothing here that look like it never just pick from the farm right now. And of course, you know, the cup of rice. And then now the pièce de résistance is the mackerel. That looks like pork. It looks great. This is a 10.
Well, Anna. KTB Wellose. Dirty girl. This is not dirty girl. This is a sophisticated big man.
Yeah.
This is not dirty girl.
Yeah.
This is not dirty girl.
No,
this the yo,
no,
let me tell you something.
No, this is fine,
hey,
sir.
Anybody who cook mackerel, give me for say, look, me don't want it, you know.
Okay.
Me don't want it. Look how mackerel look bossy. And look like he could have sell up a boozer. Vanessa. Vanessa, big up yourself. That mackerel look like it up a boozer or up a broken plate or up a hopper.
Of course.
You understand? This look like a somebody from up a lash who and it cook for. Yeah. Uptown! Uptown!
Mackerel can love mackerel. I don't know how to love
me mackerel. I tell you, this is like when mackerel get visa.
Jesus.
Uh-huh. It's a travel.
This is an international mackerel. This mackerel is an international
it is
mackerel.
Traveling!
Yeah.
That's real to God. Come again.
From downtown to uptown. On the bus. On the bus. Okay, here we go. Can we please zoom up that old bottle? It looks like rice and peas and fried chicken.
You said fried chicken.
And steamed
veg. You said market vegetable.
Yes.
What is the next meat?
And the next meat, Lord have mercy. Oh, God. Cow food?
Nope.
Pork?
Yes, it's pork. What about
pork?
That pork?
Oh, God. Governor Jerome?
I'm not a pork specialist, no.
Is, I don't know. Pork rind. Pork. Trotters. Pigfoot.
It's above the trotters. It's
Shin.
Oh, you say shin?
Anything about me for their shin?
All right. Is this pork hock?
Huh?
Pork hock.
Oh, this is what pork. They call down south name ham hocks.
Yeah.
Ham hocks.
Yeah, pork hock. So it's above the foot. Oh. A meatier part above the foot. It's like mini steaks.
Mini
boneless steaks.
Ham hocks.
Very, very inexpensive. It's a more inexpensive part of farm of pork. Mm-hmm. It is a little bit more expensive than trotters, mm-hmm. but it's very, very meaty. So if you like the gelatinous nature of the meat, plus you like the texturedness of the pork, this is a wonderful part of the pig for you to eat. It is very delicious. And I personally am going to give this food, I think it could have been done in a little bit more greener. I'm going to give it a 9.5 out of 10. I really do like the texture of the rice still. The chicken looks good. The pork hock looks well seasoned and nice. And the vegetable looks right. So I'm going to give it a 9.5 out of 10. How much you give it, Karen?
Yeah, man, this looks good. This is going to get a 9. This is going to get a 9.
Nine point five. Anyways, big up yourself. Who for one that Jerry? The person that sent them name? No? Next up. Kira, big up yourself for the pork, akan fried chicken, rice and peas, and the steamed vegetable. Now, Karen, this look like you.
What
big it up for you.
The fish again is full of okra. And then it looks like me. You can't see the fish. People, why is it that we can't see the fish these days? Since the fish that come in the net, you know, every day the fish just cover. Mm-hmm. So this fish now looks like it would have been a parrot. I think it is.
Yes.
And then now it is covered with okra and a whole heap of okra. Yeah, mm-hmm. A whole heap. So this is not my food, it's yours. And a whole heap
of trouble.
And then it has carrots. Meat. And then you know what's beautiful about this though? You know, because there's always a silver lining. Two nice dollops of mashed potatoes and sweet corn. No, but that corn don't even look like it do sweet. It kind of look.
May I tell you the truth? Nobody in them right mind mm-hmm. no want a naked steam fish.
Exactly.
Our brown steam
no, but let me say a little bit now.
Exactly. Nobody don't want a naked
fish. Little bit.
I don't know where you want
to see the fish?
No, I don't want fish with okra and seasoning. Yeah.
Where is the juice in this?
It want a little more juice.
Okay, I'm not going to lie. Just ask.
But.
Yeah.
The fish look good. The amount of okra the panita and carrot looks real good. You understand me? I say the mashed potato look proper. This not look mm-hmm. like box mashed potatoes.
So no, the color this is
looks
good.
Real good. The corn them, when I already told to dig them corn,
it looks like corn. Hero Circle corn. That
No, we didn't go there. So.
Oh, okay.
There's a ban. We talk about food. Yeah. This. Right, so that food that look good still. I'm not going to go around and still. Would I want a little more sauce upon the fish still?
Some more gravy.
A little more gravy upon the fish. Yeah. Underneath this, so could I see it? The fish are like a rest in a little water.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then sit there, we can hold up a plate and suppy.
Yeah.
But, I still have to give this a 9.5 though.
This is a 9.
What could I do without the corn then? Because hold up a mashed potato that still. I'm not going to go around. Hold up a mashed potato that. The mashed potato look very buttery and creamy and nice.
Replace the corn.
You understand? No.
Wow, this is colorful and pretty.
I fish this man.
And okra again. When you love okra, sir?
Me can't say this good.
Go on up there, go look. Why? Oh my goodness gracious. When you love okra, sir? And this is fish again?
A fish, but then slice up. See, fish
so this is sliced fish?
Fish head, no man, and a fish head, and a slice, and slice the fish, man.
Okay. So Triple says it's fish head, fish tail. All right, and it has lots of okra.
This looks like steel.
Yes, and what is that red thing? Is it tomato?
Tomato. Yes,
uh-huh.
Okra.
Uh-huh. And it's...
Pimento.
So
well seasoned and
yeah, it looks good. It looks really, really good. Guys, this looks really nice.
It's bossy, but I'm going to go around here. People, this is so bossy. The three people who... Rose from outer Spain, big up yourself, Auntie Rose.
Yeah.
Here we are going. For the persons who are driving along, this is a wok. It's a wok. A plate, the pot is a wok. Yeah. And then cut up the slice is a sliced fish. And then brown stew it down. So they like them fry the fish first.
Uh-huh.
And then them cook the sauce and put it in. And you know me like about this?
What
they never put in the okra till last. Yes. So the okra don't mash out. So the okra still look like it have like a slime and it's mixed to the right amount of crunch. Now. Yes. You understand me? I say? And this is right. This come like say whoever cook this never have no left and none of left foot because everything about this is right. I swear to you.
So so hold on a second now. You are saying now that the standard to cooking these days, especially with fish, is okra.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okra and flavor.
Yeah.
Okra and flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Big up the people that make cock soup. Inna the fish.
Mm. Well, that is a good thing.
We take the time for use this strainer and chew the cock soup inna the strainer and sieve it out.
Yes.
Because not me eat more than when it come like a fish noodle me eat and it cake up in there. I make it pot stick.
Yeah.
This looks so good. Me now go tell now. Where the woman name again? Rose, big up yourself,
this
man.
This is from Rose? Rose in Portmore?
No,
Rose from where?
No, not Rose from TikTok. Not she neither. Rose from Punish Town.
Oh?
You understand?
Rose, big up you.
That is it, man.
I like the color of the okra, at least.
It looks good, man.
Very, very, it
looks
very,
real good.
Very nice.
And I'm loving it. I am loving it. I'm telling you. You have no more over there?
Oh, my goodness gracious.
I'm going to see my work wife from Dino.
But hold on a second. This
what
this
is her?
This look like something raw. What?
I want onion that. I want this.
It looks.
I want all that onion that.
It looks like corned beef over the or in the States with thing, but.
I miss red peas.
With red peas and an onion. Yeah, that's why I'm thinking.
What I'm sitting over there,
thinking it could have been corned beef.
All right, that one
from the Irish, like Irish corned beef.
You ungraded because them no send a description. What?
Okay. I don't know. Here it is now. Here it is. It's coming. Or maybe ham. It could be ham too, you know. It could be ham too.
Hold on. So this is a red pea soup?
A red pea soup with what?
Red pea soup.
With what? And what is that?
Talk again, Nigerian, please.
Red pea soup, they're saying, in a nice blue.
She said she used a red pea soup with just red peas for seasoning, one soup mix.
Yes.
And an onion.
An onion.
Here we are going.
But now, what is that on the side? That's what I'm asking. What kind of meat is that?
And a meat.
Is what?
A piece of sweet potato.
That sweet potato? Oh. This gets a 5.
Yeah, what? 5, what? 5, what? Yeah, where's my 5?
Because it's food. I'm sorry. I can't give less than a 5.
Put up no more food. This
totally just broke my vibe right now. This what? I'm very annoyed.
Here we are going now, people. You know, saying everybody if you have stove door. Big man thing. I know everybody if you have stove.
No.
I know everybody if you have pot. I know everybody if you lower on fire.
No. And this one is a crime.
Is a crime against humanity.
Yes, it is.
Me no normally bash nobody food, but you see that somebody, huh?
This can't work.
Certified Chef Pamela, I must joke here and send this in for. Because there's no way.
What do you mean certified Chef Pamela?
And sending this.
And the peas all look like is canned peas.
People, the woman cut the onion in a 4.
Mm-hmm. And drop it.
Broadway. And then lent with.
And this person is in Jamaica? Them in Jamaica?
Me know says me know fair fox. No, here what? Pamela, me know fair fox. This is a prank. Where camera them there? A prank this though? I'm prank. This is a prank. Yeah. Me now go cuss you. Pamela, big up yourself. Love you. Thank you very much for sending in everything we are sending. But that one you write here, so?
Nah.
This is a part of your bipolar phase. Cause this.
This is crazy.
Mm-mm. No. This I no hit. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to jump in a quick commercial break. I'm going to come right back with the design studio. We don't know where I'm going, right? We'll be back.
Guilty. Out perform, out last. Guilty. We talk performance. Jack-a-ma, reliable, full stop, not comma. We have the expertise for drilling and demolition. We have the power tools for plumbers and electrician. Fan select tools, free parts and free repairs.
Free parts, free repairs.
In 2 to 3 years. Hilton, available at Delta Supply, 106 Hagley Park Road. Call us at 876-302-61114. Delta Supply, we service what we sell.
It's time for a new look.
And high time to get serious about protecting our home and investment.
It's time to choose BH Paints with over 60 years experience in quality paint finishes. Their products are superior and long-lasting.
Time to check them out.
Ask about BH Paint's 100% Acrylic Ultima Plus paint and primer in one. Experience rich colors with advanced UV and mildew-resistant technologies, independently tested by experts. What are you waiting for? Visit a BH Paint's Color Center today.
You deserve a beautiful home. Join the expert Karen Booker, your design diva, this and every Saturday at 1 to 2 p.m. here on Nationwide 90 FM. Learn what's really behind the design. Access insights and hacks that'll have your home looking like it was snatched from a magazine cover. From cushions to curtains, choosing colors to carpets, Karen will teach you the secret of the pros. That's the Design Studio every Saturday at 1 p.m. here on Nationwide 90.
The E-Zone with me, the Stinger Honey Bee, alongside
Kareem Boy Ting,
as we turn up the heat in the street.
New show,
new vibe,
same us,
same us.
Monday to Friday, 3 to 5 p.m.
right here on Nationwide 90 FM.
We'll bring you entertainment news.
We'll take away your Monday blues.
You don't want to miss a week with us.
We'll talk health,
wealth,
jump into the mix,
or the hot seat.
Don't miss the brain buster,
or the crazy giveaways.
I mean, is this planet Earth?
Is it?
I don't know, let me check. Either way, it's got a buzz.
And a buzz.
But is this real? Hey, Greg, come look at this. Oh my, it's happening. Mr. Daniels, the numbers keep getting bigger and bigger.
Sir, the clicks are off the charts.
Hello, sales. What's the emergency? 9,000 clicks in one day? 3,000 order? So how much we have left? What? I soon call you back. Mr. Nakamoto, it's Danny from Jamaica. I need 5,000 of the big ones. We're back in business.
Yes, sir. Arigato. Sweat it.
Amplify your brand. Let Nationwide 90 FM assist you in tapping into a captivated audience across our social media platforms. For more information, contact us at 876-630-1210 or sales@nationwidenewsnetwork.com. Businesses, companies, and entrepreneurs. Let's supercharge your brand.
Sound off Monday to Friday on Nationwide 90 FM. This is Beanie Man. Give it to them.
Design Lab Home Decor Tips and Design Trends is brought to you by BH Paints. Paint it, love it with BH Paints.
Hello, and we are back, and we are now in what? The Design Studio!
Yes, sir.
And today, we're in Design Lab. You know, Design Lab on Tuesdays, you know. Yes, and tomorrow it's going to be Know Your Roots, and then Thursday. Yeah, man, all the things. So today, we're joined by Head Boy here. And of course, he's going to be engaged, and he's going to get his A, because, you know, we have very, very high hopes for Head Boy. Now, we have the other one over there now, what we call him. And the thing about it is, you know, even before, that is why, you know, I'm telling you, you cannot promote somebody before they prove themselves. So, by virtue of how Mr. Jerome came in and played the music and everything, you know what we did? We just promoted him and we gave him, but he realized that he didn't take it for granted.
Yeah.
So we had to demote him a little bit, shame him a little bit, and now he is engaged. Mm. So we're going to talk about color today. We realized
people,
from...
one second, before we go no further.
Yes.
Me confess from now, you see, if you say me lose the work on Nationwide, I choose me come here come thief. The work wife never there, so me end up go thief out. So my cliff use coffee a while ago, I mix you out. Me use the last of creamer, less than 2 teaspoons of creamer they didn't there. I use too much of coffee. Caffeine coffee come like a chunk on the normal coffee. I try to sugar pan if you make it taste good, but Jesus please, it's come like a cup of diabetes me a drink over here. Chunk in a man. And the bitter said it bitter but it's sweet. You ever taste that it? Bitter but it's sweet.
But it's sweet,
too
amen.
Sweet,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
Can't drink this man. I gotta throw some more water on it.
Throw some water on it. That's what you do. Mm. You made it too strong. Lunette, wherever you are, please hurry up and come back. So by the design, you know, design quiz is every Thursday, right? I get to realize from the past 3 weeks that people don't know their colors, and they definitely don't know what primary colors are. So we're going to go through this, because I don't know if it's because, you know, we learned it too early in life. So what are our primary colors? Let us just go there first, because that is the foundation of everything else. Mr. Jerome, what are your primary colors?
Red, yellow, blue.
Very good. Yeah. All right. And from that now, Mr. Triple X, you have secondary colors. You can use red and blue and make...
Red and blue make purple.
Very good. You can use yellow and blue and you make?
Green.
And then you make, and you have oranges made from?
Yellow and red.
Very good.
That is it.
There
man.
You go. There you, and those
it,
are your secondary colors. Mm-hmm. We're not going to go into graduate school now and go with the tertiary colors and all of this, but at least you know the foundation. So when we come to you on Thursday, I will say, okay, you should know what we're talking about. All right. So here's the thing now. When it is that you are, you ever hear about a hue? You know what a hue is?
A hue, like a shade of a color?
No, it's not a shade of a color. The hue is the color.
Oh, okay.
Right? So it is now the purest form of the color without adding a tint, a shade, or a tone.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, if you have a blue and you want to add a tint to it, what color is the tint?
A color of a tint, if you want what?
A tint. If you have a blue, like a dark blue, and you want to shade it up, right? You say, because anything you
want to
shade
brighter
or a little lighter, then you would shade it, right?
With white?
White. Mm-hmm. No. White is when what you use to give shades, right? When you are tinting something.
You use black.
No. Or when you're toning it, what you use?
Black.
Black.
All right.
Okay. All right. Shades are grays, tints are whites, and tones are black. You get that?
Mm.
So, if you are wanting to do a gray in your room and you have a can of black paint, all you have to do is
mix the white in it.
Just put some white in here and you're good.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah, so they got
what
a good
saying?
Basic school, you know. They say, you know. Someone at basic school only go and they never even have water for washing their hand. When they got a good basic school, they teach them actually interested. You understand?
Yes.
It's like going good basic school, they want a whole man and a principal.
There you go.
You understand me, I say? That is it, man.
So here's the thing now. So as you know, when we come for neutral colors. And neutral colors are, you know, colors that we've added lots of gray or white in it to just make sure that it's pleasing. You good? You get that? You can usually use any color at all to go with a neutral color.
Okay.
You get that?
Okay, me understand that now.
All right, fine. So if you have a neutral color in your kitchen, so to speak, right? What color can you use for your cabinetry? You start with gray. What color can you use for your cabinetry?
Black.
Or?
White.
Or?
Purple.
Any color you want.
Okay.
Not that. Yes, any color you want.
So once you have a gray, like a gray background, you can put any color upon gray.
Exactly.
Except for yellow, because I'm here for yellow kitchen.
Yellow kitchen. And
yellow
so
kitchen.
All
right. Yes, yellow kitchen.
Let us go into the psychology of color now, right? We talked about red, right? Red is a passionate color. So it can heat you up. Actually, it can make you hot. All right? So you don't want to put red where?
In your bedroom.
Or in another place, in like a children's bedroom where you want them to just settle and so on. Where can you put red?
Red. In your living room?
In your living room, but not all over.
It has to be like an accent wall.
An accent wall. It can be a playroom. It can be an entertainment room.
Mm-hmm.
You know, any kind of a den. All right. Blue now. Tell me about blue.
Blue is supposed to be calming and soothing
and
cool.
And peaceful. Mm-hmm. Right. So blues you would use in, you know, people use blues in the bathroom a lot. But it's not because, you know, it's calming and peaceful. Just got to associate blue with water.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Another beautiful color for your bathroom is like an aqua. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? All right.
Aqua like a sea
aqua
green.
Like a sea green, but okay. Very, very, like a sea foam. Very, very light and so on. All
like
right.
It's a white bathroom.
White bathrooms are now in. White bathrooms are in, but if you are a messy person, the white will only last for the very day that it was painted, and after that you're not going to, it's going to turn gray if you don't clean it every single day. Mm-hmm. Right? Okay. My first kitchen was white and I regretted it for a whole year because I was cleaning every single, I'm going to tell you, clean? No. Mm-mm. So unless, all right, fine. Okay, so let us talk about these pictures that we have here now. So we've talked about Miss Jereen. All right, look at this kitchen. Look at this. You don't have on your glasses. You couldn't just run outside, go get your glasses. All right, Mr. Jerome, you see this living room here?
Yes.
It has accent chairs of the aqua. Uh-huh. Yes, and background
blue,
color.
A royal blue then in the middle.
A royal, mm-hmm. blue, nice a royal blue in the middle as an ottoman.
That's nice though.
And then gray sofa and so on. And then you bring
it. Have some bossy place. Where
yes.
Some place where just yeah. The roof where high.
And it's high, exactly.
Now, the
thing is now, when it is that you have high ceilings, your home actually goes right up. It appreciates because it gives you more real estate.
Mm.
You understand? So even though the square footage may not increase, once you increase that ceiling height, you're good already. You're gone.
That means they matter than us, they don't work nothing then.
You're gone. You're gone.
Then the roof, they have to bend down when they turn up in there.
Yeah, you have to turn it. But it's still house, so it will appreciate. Yeah. It will appreciate. So the moral of this story here is once you start neutral, you can have your jumping off points with your accent colors. You know, but just don't use too much accent colors on your wall, because if you do that, everything is just going to fight and it's not going to be as peaceful as you would want. All right. We have some more pictures, miss. Thank you very much. All right. Baby's room here. The baby's room. Usually what we're doing these days in baby's room is to do non-gender specific. You're not going to see pink and blue anymore, but you will see colors of, you know, like that aqua there with coral, with so on. So, you know, the baby, it's just a thing, you know, and then next year it will be something else. So non-gender specific colors for children's rooms these days.
Okay. All right. I got you.
Any more? Okay. All right. Here is this one. Minuting.
Hold on. Is this all non-gender specific? Is because you pick them when they turn and they start growing, they start changing their gender.
It is because of the LGBTQ, A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
No, sorry.
Yes. And this is what we call about influences.
Influences. Going to be blue. Yes. If a girl, you're going to have pink things in there.
We have a lot of people who are influencing these days and making up these rules, and they have a lot of clout. And because of that, they figure that we should change the spectrum. As we just said in the first segment here, that listen, wrong is wrong, right is right. And not because people have strong opinions now means it becomes right.
They must go beat me.
So here it is. This is a very... And another thing that is very trending these days is what now? Look at this picture and tell me exactly what is trending. People,
that mustard color there.
Uh-huh. That's mustard. The okra, right? And
in the okra?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okra and green.
But has nothing to do with it. Sometimes the way they name the colors has nothing to do with the actual thing itself. But that color, and it is very, very trending. But there's something else in this picture. For people who are riding around, we're looking at a really beautiful picture of a dining space. What is the black table? And then it's a ginger.
Different type of
chairs.
Chairs, yeah.
Right. But there's one thing that I need you. Jerome, you don't see it.
A vase?
No.
The lighting fixture?
No. Go up some more now. Go up Lamp some more now. Go up
roof,
some more now.
The
ceiling. Exactly. Okay. Ceilings are being painted now in different colors.
I like it.
Yes. Ceilings are now being painted.
Much
yeah.
Much, mm-hmm. much
but in this room here, you have sage walls and sage is green. And then you have a tray ceiling. And the top part of this tray ceiling is in a pumpkin color, a terracotta. And then you have the gold colors of the okra and so on. So it really, it has like a Tuscan look. You know what I'm saying? Jerome, you need to let the people know that you really are... paying attention and doing and yes, talking, you know, you're engaging. Yes, because that is the only way your grade is going to mm-hmm. increase. Yes, so people, let me tell you something. Another thing, and then we're going to go. If you have a room that you're kind of stuck on and you don't know the palette, go to the fabric store. Get yourself a nice colored fabric or, you know, like a floral or so on. And then you know, you can take that fabric. You can take the background color of that fabric. You get me? And then set the palette of your room. And that is a little trick that we use all the time. You use either an inspiration fabric, whole heap of colors on it, mm-hmm. and then or a rug. And then you can set a palette from that. What do I mean by palette? What colors you're going to use in the room. And the palette is not... Yeah. And palette is not necessarily just the wall. It can be the wall, the sofa, the accent pillars, the curtains, everything. All the colors that go into
see,
the
room. Like in time, I get dressed. I always tell people, you get dressed out from my shoes first.
Yeah.
So you get the shoe first, and mm-hmm. then like, if you don't know how to wear, mm-hmm. buy a shoe first. Mm-hmm. And then you use the colors from the shoes.
Right.
And try to match back throughout the outfit, or try to get things to get the shoes. If you want the shoes to stand out, mm-hmm. you use a neutral base, and then use the shoes as the accent piece.
Okay, that's how you dress?
Mm. Yeah, man.
Oh!
When we are going out, when we are bossing
up, bossing up the thing. Mm. All right, so people, this is it for Design Studio today in the Design Lab, brought to you by BH Paints. We love them.
We got BH Paint.
Yes, BH, I remember they have these little pots of paint.
May I look 10 gallon of paint here?
Yeah? You hear that, BH? Tracy, Marvin.
Tracy, Marvin.
Sharon.
I remember say we don't really get paid much money as a nationwide, so we can't afford.
We could go and make Triple's house a project and film it. Bring all the scheme. Yeah. Mm. Mm-hmm. Okay, then. All righty. All right, guys. Go up on a little break and we come right back.
Design Lab home decor tips and design trends was brought to you by BH Paints. Paint it, love it with BH Paints.
Tune in to Nationwide 90FM, the new revolution in media. Stay ahead of the curve with our cutting-edge reporting and accurate breaking news coverage.
We're having an earthquake. Oh, God.
Hear it here first on Nationwide 90FM.
Is that really clip you started?
Tune in, turn up the volume, and listen. We bring a mix of news, entertainment, and sports to your lives.
Nationwide 90FM's live and continuous coverage of the World Championships in Budapest, Hungary.
News and discussions week mornings.
Coming up in the news at 6 for this morning.
Entertainment in the afternoons, then news again in the evenings.
Nationwide news at this hour, fired.
Also, tune in to the entertainment and sports shows in the nights and on the weekends.
It is Boya Ting's After Dark Retro on Nationwide 90FM.
Everything is news, from current affairs and entertainment to sports, business, and other categories.
Nationwide 90FM. This is me, man. Give it to them. Zaga, Zen.
From every whisper to every commotion.
That's rubbish. The KSAMC cannot investigate itself.
Was Click News really talking like that?
Every news story unfolds here first at Nationwide 90FM, the new revolution in media. Every sound is a story, and every story we share is news.
The Olympic Games 2024, live from Paris in France, exclusively on Nationwide 90FM.
The Jamaican star shines bright once again.
This summer, Nationwide 90FM is coming in hot.
Jamaica to the blocks!
Nationwide 90FM will be blazing as we bring you the games of the 33rd Olympiad live from the French capital, Paris. 16 fantastic days of competition in 41 sports.
Lovely Williams bells coming!
The station will bring you analysis and live coverage from the opening day of competition, Friday, July 26th, to the very last day of action on Sunday, August 11th.
And some parchment! Let's go! Oh, what a run!
Everything and anything Paris Olympic Games 2024 can be heard right here on Nationwide 90FM.
It is a glittering gold for Sharika Jackson, and how they will celebrate that back in Jamaica.
We'll capture the spirit of athleticism. We'll narrate the Olympic fever, define thrilling moments, and report on the blood, sweat, and tears of the world's greatest athletes. Nationwide 90FM is going to the Paris Olympic Games, and we're taking you with us. tune into Nationwide 90.3, 90.5, 90.7, and 90.9 for live updates and commentary. We'll be giving the listeners a front row seat to witness excitement, triumph, and memories.
And I think it was a clean sweep for the Jamaicans.
Stay tuned to Nationwide 90 FM 24/7. Experience the Paris Olympic Games 2024 right here on the Revolution in Media Nationwide 90 FM, your Olympic Center. Exclusively on Nationwide 90 FM.
So now, Monday to Friday, on Nationwide 90 FM. This is Beanie Man. Give it to them, Zaga. Zen.
Ladies, let me tell you something. I don't know why Jamaican men love toxic women, so why Jamaicans love toxic relationships. No matter what the song, the mad, you still look at them and say. Let me talk, man, make Jerome play, man. Come, Jerome. Ladies, please do remember that today is Troublesome Tuesdays. I see the views expressed by Triple X and Karen are not necessarily those of Nationwide.
Exactly.
Listen, the topic we are going to go on, I don't want nobody to come say, Cliff Hughes, I promote this. Nationwide, I promote this. This beautiful young lady over to my left hand side, her name is the Design Diva. She's Karen Booker.
Yes.
You understand? Mm-hmm. She's an independent entity of this station. For those who don't know, I myself, I'm Daryl Anthony Cummings, a.k.a. Triple X. God. In some circles, I am known as Mr. Krabs. I am an independent entity, separate and apart from Nationwide. The views expressed in this segment of Troublesome Tuesdays are ours and ours alone.
Yes.
Now, for the persons out there who are social media inclined, do remember that this is an entertainment show, correct?
Yes.
And we comment on entertainment of every kind.
Of every kind.
But here,
of every kind.
Jerome,
and
play
it is entertainment.
Play the music and entertain the people first before going to the nitty gritty. Thank you.
Girl, if I could shed you all, like a snake skin out of your toxic and venomous. When I leave you, forever and ever. Cheat and you cheat and cheat and cheat. Oh, I believe you. When I leave you, I'm here you forever and ever. Cheat and you cheat and cheat. You're not for greater scene. Look how you deal with me. Rough like alligator skin. Them say I have a look of man, but never get a feel. Yes, I'm a bad, but you don't even know what behavior me. You are the thing we want for door. Sexy like juggling, go catch on the call. Love your tongue, ring me, don't want my radio. But you want me to get harder for you.
Speaking on the phone, but cheating. She have a man, she want anything. That's why she's a chef.
Am I the only person who noticed? I don't want you to play nothing else but Dexter Dubs for the next three songs.
Because I'm troublesome.
Am I the only person who noticed that every single song that Dexter Dubs put out has something to do about infidelity? Am I the only person who noticed that Dexter Dubs has never ever encouraged women to stick by your man's side and stand firm in the man's life and be a good woman?
You think Am it's I the because only one? He's what you say now?
All right. And
attracted to a certain
Thank
guy.
You very much, Jerrine. Jerrine has also pointed out another point.
What you think?
He has never ever influenced a woman to leave your man completely and come there with me.
Because he's about that life.
He's always instigating for women to tell a man a lie,
yeah.
Come and visit me.
He is about that life.
Let us have a conjugal interaction
and go
then go on back to your man. play next Dexter, but if you think I lie, me, I tell. Play next one.
We up all night, speaking on the phone, but cheating. She have a man, but you want anything. That's why she says she have reasons. She says she, but she just an artist. We can't be friends. Make sure you get an feeling. Look like they need a new replacement. You can never, never make a statement. No, we know. We know what I mean, also leave. No grass, no green. On the other side. She love it to it her time.
Ladies, beware of these silver tongue, the devils. Ladies, beware of these silver tongued devils.
I am so glad I'm off the market.
The grass is not greener it's on the next
green.
Side.
It's only green.
Because of the angle where you look on it, make the grass look green over there. So, ladies, I'm going to tell you this straight. You see, if a man see you with a next man and him influence you, if he come to him, you see, the moment when you left your man in an entirety and try to fling yourself at a man's foot.
Not a good move. Him gone.
Him gone.
Because the challenge is over. They love the chase.
It is not about you.
It's a chase.
It is not about you.
Oh, God.
If I, in a Jamaica, they have one sitting where they say, do swap maga dog for black monkey.
No, I go, don't swap monkey for... All right, it'll come.
Our monkey for maga dog. Same thing.
Yeah.
You see the man where you're there with? Mm-hmm. Him have him dirty ways and him crossing all ways. Our crossistic elements to him. You see the new man where you get?
What, sir?
Him willing for you be unfaithful to the man where they're there. I help you out, pay your bills, them and everything, and I support you, and I bring you through your thick or your thin. Remember, say the new man only see you in your luster and your glowing, you know. Him not say they glow up. So when you set some pack up your things and run, go over there. So go and go, if all means, if you's a frolicker, go and go frolic in a Babylon and come back. But don't go set some pack up your things them and migrate, go over Babylon. It's a go rough over there. Play one next one of the cheated no, ambassador of Jamaica.
It going. Go.
She was a single first. She made me feel like it at the channel. I'm in a cute world. Most of this the really cause the drama call up in true words. She take a stock when me say that and I be for sale of the single first. And I say, oh,
that's when things reach them though, no, then I'm sorry. But what you do care about, don't it?
You see where they do?
Care about?
Better you never did do
it. Better you never did do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to come back. We're going to take a quick break and we're going to come right back. And we are going to something at.
Can I just tell you? Today is the day of characters.
Mm-hmm.
When you hear what I've got to say. Public opinions.
Stop this foolish about this GLP and PMP business. We are a Jamaican.
Different people.
It's not a matter of a JLP or a PMP. I think it's more like where it is that you think you're comfortable, what support you can afford to make the country better.
Different views.
Most entertainers, they're not amenable to management, so the only thing that can ultimately structure them is the court and the prison.
Public opinion. The voice of the people at 6:25 p.m. weekdays during Nationwide at 5. Tune into Nationwide at 6:25 p.m. for Public Opinion, where the people's views matter.
Public Opinion is brought to you by Cleasing Industrial Supplies Limited, Industrial Automation and Control Solutions.
Not a mercy. This one is very classic, dedicated to all schoolers who are taking
them. If you've ever struggled to pass an exam, then you'll know that students today are under great pressure to get good grades and secure qualification needed to move on to higher education. The problem is that too many students are struggling alone and could really benefit from connecting with hardworking teachers and other bright students in other parts of the country and the region. Join me, Dennis Brooks, this and every Friday evening from 8 to 9, with a repeat on Saturday morning from 8 to 9. For the A-Team, a study group on radio, my team of teachers, students, and experts will break down the syllabus, giving you information, tips, and past paper questions that will help you get top grades in your upcoming exams. Follow us on Facebook Live and on Twitter and be a part of the community. It's the A-Team. Fridays at 8 p.m. with a repeat at 8 o'clock on Saturday morning. It's your free extra class on radio and social media. And it's right here on Nationwide 90 FM, the revolution in media.
So now, Monday to Friday on Nationwide 90 FM.
Okay, so guys, you know, I've been telling you, or we have been just, you know, prefacing all kind of exactly disclaimers. We are good over here, so we're not even going into that already because Triple did a wonderful job. But we've been going into, you know, a series of characters today. Everybody on that we've featured has some kind of thing going on. So, you know, last week, right? We came up with, you know, Ivani Wright, who is this big influencer based on the foolishness that she does. She's now being, she's on the screen for everybody to see. So here's the thing now. There's more to this ongoing saga of dysfunction, right? Following her arrest several days ago, information has now surfaced that, you know, Ivani was placed at a jail in the state of Georgia. Amid speculations about her future, her mugshot was released on Monday, which is April 8th, which was yesterday. In the photo, Ivani had on a green colored top with a white undershirt. Notably, she gave a stern facial expression in the now circulating photo. So here's the thing now. Ivani Wright was placed at the Henry County Jail following her arrest on the 4th of April 2024. That was last week. So her initial bond was set at zero, indicating that she was not eligible for release on bail, according to Henry County Jail's website. Ivani received two charges, one for terrorist threats and acts, and another for criminal damage to property, second degree damage, greater than $500, with a total bond set at $1,050. Ivani is one of them girls, you see, who she does her thing and she does it and she does, and then you have this whole mass of people who are just clamoring and can't get enough of the foolishness that she does. Now she lives without any kind of accountability. She lives like she's a sociopath, a real misfit. Again, my views. Right? And there's no accountability. So the more views she gets with the foolishness is the more she amps up. And she ramps up. Now the problem is with this Ivani Wright situation is she has a baby. And she uses the baby as clickbait. And the baby is just there with her. And she has this baby father. His props, exactly. And then she has a baby father who... him just as bad.
Him not so sensible neither. No.
Exactly.
Him look like him have couple of things missing to him. No.
So it is just this thing, as I said today, Tuesday is a day of polarizing people. So people, let me take it to your man and me with just.
Whether or not you know if you agree or not, everything will happen to her right now, a fear fault.
Absolutely.
Fear fault. If you are going to share any of the blame for this, you have to put it upon her, the consumers of her content. The truth of the matter is, people been a tell a little girl and I want a little girl and say, listen to me, man. Something bad is going to happen. Something I got them. Remember, say, you're in the people them country. I seek asylum. Asylum don't mean you automatically get in. Who remember? I think it was about a year ago. An asylum seeker. M-U-R-D-E-R-E-D. American citizen over there.
Oh, Lord.
The American citizen actually reported the asylum seeker to the authorities, and they held on to him and let him go. And after them let him go, he went and he ended her life. You understand? So after that was happened, laws and legislations were put in place within 48 hours of the incident. Within 48 hours of the conviction, laws were put in place for excommunication of asylum seekers.
Yes.
So like once upon a time, you could have done certain and certain things, and there are certain and certain crimes, whether or not you want to look upon them as misdemeanors or not. There are certain crimes that once you do these crimes, these are immediate removal. You get placed in the removal process.
Yeah.
Immediately after certain and certain things. Now, the truth of the matter is this. Me no wish bad upon nobody. You understand me? And this is what me see. You see, if things are going good for you, Jamaica, and you take up yourself and go foreign, there are so many opportunities in America to make yourself better. You understand? We understand, say, Jamaica is the land of food and water. We love Jamaica. Because me personally, I love Jamaica going to bed. But at the end of the day, you have certain opportunities that persons from lower socioeconomic groups can't really get in a Jamaica that are available in America. A lot of persons say America rough and America hard, but there are so many social nets that are there to help you catch you and pick you up. What's as an immigrant going over there for the first time, you can go and try to make it. Ivani was in a better standing than 90% of the persons who went over there as immigrants.
I agree. I totally agree.
She went over there with a large family, with a large support system from social media.
Yep.
A means to make massive earnings while she was there. And a means also to make herself
a new life, a better life, and
everything. What happened is this. Mm-hmm. This young lady from Shidea, Jamaica, she has, as you said, Karen, there is no accountability for her action, and she pursued or continued with this lack of accountability over there.
Yeah.
Whatever it is that she did, she created a social network of an echo chamber for persons to jeer her on or to say, yes, girl, go on to this. And even now that she's incarcerated, you have people under the post are saying, "Low the girl, una too bad mind, una too this, una too that." No, look and say, listen, you actually watch this train wreck occur from the left the station. Mm-hmm. Your sister, the train was off the rails. It had to end in tragedy. And now that it is has become the tragedy unfold, on a still a support, on a still now pull back and say, boy, Lord, make sure take her beating. I'll try to figure out some level of accountability. Una say, no worries, she go, all right, car, we are going to take care of her,
Una not
going to stop until a little girl have ramped with the wrong person, and then her life comes to an end. There has to come a point where you have to make an intervention for no sorry, because this little girl, prisoner Umblar, she got a prisoner Jamaica already, and she come back out
and
to
she
worse.
Come back out. But what I'm trying to say about this girl too is, like, not only that she has any accountability, she doesn't have any moral standing. She really doesn't know right from wrong. When you look at her behavior and how it goes from good, what good? It goes from bad to worse to, my God, how could you? And it goes to something else. So when you think that she reached a new low, she gets lower and she gets lower and she gets lower. And then she has this audience now who cheers her on. So when you have somebody like that who really don't have no kind of compass as to, okay, or temperature check as to, okay, let me just stop here. You know, I kind of reached too far now. She goes higher and she goes and she goes. She keeps pushing these boundaries.
Virgin.
So it was just a matter of time. But hear this thing now. You see, when you're in another man's country, you must take time, especially if you are seeking asylum. And you know, Miss Ivani, your life is playing right there, make everybody see. So even if you could have said, kind of find a lawyer who want to take your case and have something for the, don't have much to do with themselves, and take your case and say, all right, let me see now how I can help this girl. Let me see how I can even take it from another angle. There's no angle to take it from, because everything is out there and everything is bad.
Everything was documented. And she video
That's
everything.
What I'm saying. Everything
she video
is
everything
out there.
And put up on herself.
Yes.
It's self-incriminating to the fullest. Ah, here we go now. Here we go now. Realest way.
I don't want to give this girl too much money.
Realest way. I see enough people that say, everybody make mistake. That is true. But this person never make a mistake. Everything we should do, she was purposefully
intentional.
It is intentional. This is not no mistake. Everything we should do, she did it knowing the consequences and repercussions. She herself was on her phone talking about the necessary consequences that could take place. And she herself said that she don't care.
There you go.
She just want to forget fear upon her flesh.
Sure,
even
right
where
right.
She never even believes it's supposed to go. Now, the truth of the matter is, I'm telling you something. Man them out here and ladies out there. Sometimes we see some people and we bring them in our life. I mean, I talk to our baby father now. Mm-hmm. And you feel like, say, because it's pretty, or because she pretty, or because she look nice and them something, you feel like something. You have certain and certain things. Let me tell you something. I don't believe, say, you no need to put a seed inside of nobody or have no pity for nobody until you really and truly know the person. Me say ladies have children for man where them don't even know how much pity the man have.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
You meet a man within a 3 months, 4 months, 5 months,
yeah,
you're pregnant for the man?
Yeah.
That make no sense? And when I talk about say, oh, marriage to me is less of a commitment than being a co-parent with somebody. Mm-hmm. Because marriage is where you can't done, you know. Mm-hmm. You can't just sit and get legal document and done. But once a child coming, you are tied to this person forever.
Yeah.
Life.
Yeah.
And I gotta tell you this. You're not gonna ever meet a woman on the road or a man on the road and them come to you and them first impression and say, you know what I mean, is a mad man? Mm-hmm. Or you know what I mean, is a mad mm-hmm. girl? Mm-hmm. She's not gonna come. They're gonna come put them best foot forward in the dating and the courting phase. So you have to look past all of the smoke and the mirrors. You have to get to know the person, know them who them their own, who them family is, and all them something there. We need to really and truly think about who it is that we allow in our body and off on our body and them something there. We need to personalize sexual encounters them. We need to stop commercialize our sexual encounters them as just something to do, as something we have made.
And now it's called the error.
We just commoditize sex.
And we just
make it so. And you better even know if it's really and truly.
But you know what, too? Mental health issues, because this girl is clearly unstable. You understand what I'm saying? And you women, you know when you're dealing with somebody who is clearly unstable. That is not the time now to go and impregnate them or make a baby, make a family, whatever.
You
because
know what
the
is?
Person is unstable. She's unstable.
You know what this? You know what this? She did a Jamaica for a long time,
a run road.
I remember, yeah. Fear Body Count, a national treasure, you know.
Yes.
So everybody knows,
yes,
it, you know.
Everybody.
You understand?
Mm-hmm,
so she been around the world.
Around
and
the
Yep. And with all of the bins she been around the world, none of the Jamaican them we know her. Mm-hmm. Never choose to plant a seed on the ground. And as soon as she reach a foreign, I meet an American. When I know nothing about her, him said so, I'm plant seed. Because anybody who did have any idea about who this woman is, in the studio right now, Rasta, raise off and show off hand. All of those who would impregnate a woman of Ivani's persuasion or history, please raise your hand. Jerome,
okay,
sit down and hand them.
All hands are down. All hands are down.
Everybody hand is down. May I tell you this? Brother, when you see certain people, you don't see problem.
I am sure to she probably thought that this was her ticket as well to get pregnant and have this child. And you know, because of the whole naturalization process in America. But this is not the way to go. So ladies, you know me, I will just say, listen to me now. Certain things you must not get yourselves involved in, even if you feel.
No, for them money, I'm madman to you.
Exactly.
But anyways,
so I'm
Karen,
turning it there.
Sorry for cut you, but the time is done.
Oh my God, it's 2:59.
Ladies and gentlemen,
tomorrow we're going to talk about.
Do enjoy the rest of the day. Have a wonderful day. And please do remember, be very cautious. Who you let in your space.
Yeah, because certain things cannot be rubbed out.
That is it. Big
exactly.
up on yourself.
You can't rub out a baby.
You know, so stepping into the next half of the entertainment block, it is the E-Zone with Karim Boya. Things are Stinger, Honey B, and my brother, Dana V. You understand? Big up on yourself. See you in the same place, same time, tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. We'll be back. We promise.
Na 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 na
feel a piece of tire, but when they want. I don't love me, really love you, me just feel it off the cheek with you. Now I can't really love you, but you know my body needs to know.